morning. Happy Thursday, PASW staff, clients, and friends joining us. Almost through the week. I mean, we're just going through these. You guys are doing great work. Tomorrow we see your film screening results for Little Princess. That's going to be a lot of fun. You guys did great work, and it's just a very fun, vibrant scene, you know, to share. So we're going to see that a few times, you know, like 10 times, because it's cool to see the same scene with different music every time. But, and I hope you enjoyed Jesus Christ Superstar. Rock opera. We're revisiting rock operas, right, this week, and that's in rock musicals. And we looked at how maybe Oliver maybe was one of the first, because it blended folk pop music with musical theater. Very simplistic songs. Jesus Christ Superstar, it's not, it doesn't sound like Oliver, and they're not, it's not very simplistic like that, but it, we just have to look at maybe the influence of it. Because, I mean, we looked at Shostakovich saying yesterday that he said he wished he wrote this. And we're going to revisit Shostakovich soon, in a few weeks. Next week, I think. And Shostakovich sounds nothing like Andrew Lloyd Webber. It's confusing, but it's cool to hear people's influences. And so today we're going to revisit a really quirky one that we looked at a long time ago. And let's take a look at Popeye. Popeye came out in 1980, at the end of the year of 1980, directed by Robert Altman. Altman, don't know if we've talked about, but Altman is was a maverick director, meaning he was very he was an independent type director, part of the New Hollywood era. And we did talk about that New Hollywood kind of in the late 60s, 70s, where films were kind of becoming more personal films. And Scorsese was, and you know, the 70s was the rise of Scorsese and Altman and other directors, and William Friedkin with the French Connection. So that's the group that Altman's from. This movie is nothing like a typical Altman film, or rather any kind of typical of any film. It's completely cartoon-like, literally cartoon-like. So we're going to be looking at the movie. And it's a musical. It's got all original songs, words and music by Harry Nilsson. So we're going to look at the music. We're going to look at where it was filmed, and it's going to be a lot of fun. See what you think. It's like I said, it's a quirky, offbeat thing, but just go with it. Trust me, go with it. It's going to be a lot of fun. So welcome to the class of Popeye. So the movie's written by Jules Feiffer and stars Robin Williams, as you can see. I mean, this is his first feature film. He was right off of Mork and Mindy. So this is his first real acting, the start of a great acting career. Obviously, he was an amazing stand-up comedy performer, and Mork and Mindy was huge. And so this was his first huge role. I mean, he is Popeye the Sailor Man. And it also stars Shelley Duvall as the perfect Olive Oil. I don't think anyone could argue that they wanted Gilda Radner, and they wanted Lily Tomlin too, but went to her, which was great. She was another favorite of Altman's. And, you know, it's a simple story. I mean, it follows, you know, Popeye and comes to this Sweet Haven town. So Sweet Haven is the, you know, fictional place, and the set's in Malta. So kind of in the island. Okay, so let's go there. Let's see what the life is like there. So yesterday we were in space, right? 2001. Okay, let's go to Malta on the island of where they filmed. And they pretty much built this. Well, they did. There was nothing here before. They built this whole little town, little village, and they all lived there. They partied there. I'm talking about the cast and the crew. And they were going to take it down, but then after 2 years after the movie, they just decided to leave it. And now it's a theme park. It's like Popeye Land or something like that. And you can go and visit it. So it's gorgeous. It's, you know, it just looks so refreshing with that blue water. So it's a southern European island in the Mediterranean Sea. The cinematographer is Giuseppe Rotuno. And he shot a lot of Fellini films. And we talked about Nina Rota and Fellini. He did Satyricon and Casanova and Amacord, So it makes sense. I didn't know that, but for some reason, watching Popeye growing up did remind me somewhat of Fellini's kind of cartoon-like, circus-like environments. And so when I saw that, I was like, of course, that makes sense. So he's using Fellini's DP, and Altman, he's got a great style of filming, and they're almost in different worlds, but they're not like fantasy worlds like Fellini. It's almost like reality slowed down, or in a different, it's realism, but there's a sense of discovery with how Altman films and tells his story. And there's always stuff going on, either in the background, conversations. It's atmospheric, so it's very realistic, but it's also like, it almost puts you as the viewer looking around at people doing things, people talking, and you're not understanding things, you're not hearing everything, especially with Popeye, because as we can see, Robin Williams is, you know, he's got the pipe, the one eye, you know, he's mumbling a lot of the time, so there's also dialogue and kind of satirical, kind of funny lines uttered.
What a cool week it is. Hey! What is this? This is the orchestra, tits. There always seems to care. You've got so much to bear, ma'am. Can I blow me too? That's it. That. Oh, it's the wind and air. Just trying to double dare. Blow me down. Paradise, mate, baby. Blow me down. It's no bother, but.
Look over there. There's strangers coming.
You'd rather not, huh? Well, that's easy to see. Wherever I go, nice looking knees. It does it for me. I can't believe that. It's a lovely day. It's still a perfect day, but maybe you would like to come down again.
So it takes 7 months to build this set in Malta. So at this time, the other studio in 1980. So Annie was the other big musical happening in this year. And if you think, and I love Annie, but if you look at that, that's nothing like Popeye. And they were both kind of competing with each other a little bit. And Annie's this big Broadway musical. Popeye is kind of the anti-musical, almost. They do break into song, but it's the songs are kind of part of their, like, just everyday life. And just part of this Sweet Haven universe. They're, you know, we'll talk about the music, but I think the huge failure of Popeye wasn't that it didn't make money. It actually made a lot of money. It was shot for $20 million. Worldwide went on to make about $60 million. So that's pretty good. But I think either critics or fans were disappointed that an iconoclastic maverick director like Altman chose to do something so kind of square, or so, you know, I don't think him doing this fit the description of a cutting edge director, which if that's the case, that's kind of, you know, stupid. I mean, it's completely clever. It's such an original. I mean, I can see why people don't like it. I love it. I mean, I grew up with it, so that's why. But and I've talked to other people that also really like it too. So I just think it's got so much heart, and it really shows you how great of an actor Robin Williams is, even though he's young and starting out, and he'll become a fantastic actor in many other roles. You see this comical character, but there's certain moments of his acting with Sweet Pea or with Olive Oil, of such tender moments, and you really see him kind of come into such a vulnerable, sweet actor.
Nothing feels better than a rose on the sea.
And I can't think of anyone but you to stay with me. Stay with me.
Stay with me.
Stay with me.
Stay with me.
Stay with me. Stay with me.
Stay.
So Harry Nilsson, the very famous American singer-songwriter, so influential with his voice and his odd kind of quirky songs. Altman and he and Altman collaborated on this. A lot of people weren't sure about it. The music's unconventional. They're ditties. They're songs, but it's almost like you can sing them, you can whistle them. The lyrics are kind of dry and hilarious in some way. I mean, they're very straightforward. I mean, the songs are just really funny and very catchy.
That's true. He may not be the best, but he's large. And he's mine.
And he can have him.
And I mentioned that Van Dyke Parks did all the arrangements and orchestrations. We did a class on Van Dyke Parks. And actually, if you take a look right here, he makes a little cameo. That's Van Dyke playing the piano in the brothel. So that's kind of cool. And I've asked him about that. He said it was fun hanging out on that island for all that, for those times. And there were some crazy times over there. So, but the music is, I guess the way Altman did it was weird. He had the cast sing their musical numbers live. So usually, you know, you sync that later. But some reason, I don't know. I mean, everyone was high and drunk probably, but some reason they all did it. They sang it live and on camera, which is unconventional. And that's why the studio album, the soundtrack doesn't match the tracks even heard in the film. The best song in it and really the song that brings so much heart to the movie. I mean, it's kind of this silly cartooning movie that's got, you know, quirks and kind of you know, satire, is He Needs Me. That song really makes the movie, I feel like it elevates it into really like something dreamy. And the scene and the song is one of my favorites in all of my life. And, for, you know, just one of my favorite moments.
It's like a dime a dance. I'll take a chance. I will because he needs me. No one ever asked before, because they never needed me.
But I do.
But he does. Maybe it's because he's so alone. Maybe it's because he's never had a home. He needs me, 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 he needs me. For once in life, I finally felt that someone needed me. And if it turns out real, then love can turn the wheel. Because he needs me, 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 he needs me. Da 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 da.
It's such a simple song. It's almost lazy, and the way Shelley Duvall sings it, it's chromatically. It's almost anyone can play that melody. Da 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 da. You can just plunk those notes, and from the piano or whatever. Paul Thomas Anderson makes brilliant use of it in his very funny, quirky, brilliant film Punch Drunk Love, which I love. And I remember seeing it in the theater when I was in 11th grade with my sister at the Sunset Five. And I heard He Needs Me come through, and I got really confused because I said, wait a second, I haven't heard this song since I was a little kid in Popeye. And I went over to Sasha, my sister, and I said, did you hear that? That's from Popeye. And I think she said, yeah, I heard it. And it took me back to my childhood, and it really opened up a door because I forgot how much I loved that song. So the melodies and scenes are just unforgettable. The set design is great. It makes you feel like you're part of that town. You're in part of that beautiful weather with that gorgeous water. It's such an interesting little quirky film. I know that probably half of you are probably very confused and the other half wants to join in this universe. I think it's so playful and childlike, and there's something so amazing about this movie. This musical, you know, we do musicals every now and then, and this is something I thought of a few weeks ago. I was like, oh, we got to do something on Popeye. So hope you enjoyed this. This is a lot of fun. Robert Altman's 1980 Popeye, Harry Nilsson and Van Dyke Parks music score. So that was good that we looked at Robert Altman, because a very famous director passed away now. But I mean, I should choose some more film scoring movies. I was just thinking for our Monday class, because a maverick director. We talked about that term. And we talked about New Hollywood a lot. And I'm just giving him credit, because it's really, this movie is so odd, right? I mean, it's a comic book, you know, movie. And Altman has this weird style, like what I just mentioned, of kind of a slowed down reality. Proust does that too with his writing. It's a slowed down reality, which sounds like it could be boring. And I don't know how. And I don't think Altman and Proust are alike at all. It just reminded me suddenly. I don't know how you make a slowed down reality interesting. Because to me, it just sounds like you would get kind of tired. Like if I were to do this class and took twice or three times the length of what I'm just saying, and if I were to slow down the tape, that could be boring. So how do people, writers and directors, how do they say, well, let's not make it boring? And sometimes it is boring, but let's not make it boring. Let's slow down reality and just capture something and keep moving with that. Interesting, right? I mean, it's just an ideas kind of that are coming to my head right now. That has nothing to do with it. But Robin Williams, what a great actor, was a great actor, and his first movie in this. And you know, I don't think of it as an anti-musical, but you know, it's a little bit. It's probably, this is the closest to Oliver. They're singable ditties. And Oliver has ditties, and Harry Nilsson wrote, you know, ditties. They're songs, but they're not fully formed, but that's the purpose. They're not supposed to be symphonic, you know, thoroughly composed pieces. Harry Nilsson didn't want that. Robert Evans, the producer, who knows what they wanted, but I mean, and Van Dyke Parks with that lovely orchestration. So, it's just interesting, you know, it's funny because Annie, you know, we talked about Annie, that comes out the same year, totally a different type of musical. That one was way more successful, but because it's still being put on, I don't know, I doubt anyone's putting on Popeye, which is okay, but I mean, a different style of songs, right? One's not better than the other, it's just a matter of taste. Because I like both equally. I love Annie as much as Popeye, but they sound so different. So, I don't know. It was good to revisit and go to that beautiful island of Malta. So, yeah, that's it. I was just kind of thinking of more thoughts to, you know, talk about with you guys. Okay, so tomorrow we see Little Princess. So get a good night's sleep tonight and be ready for tomorrow. Okay, have a great rest of the day and see you tomorrow. Bye.